It's hard to see, harder still to comprehend. Plastics have become so pervasive in our world that researchers have found them deeply embedded in Arctic ice, far from anywhere humans live.
We can all agree on the urgency of the issue, like we need to do something right now to decrease the amount of plastics that gets into the ocean.
The numbers are hard to swallow. According to the United Nations, only 9% of the more than 8 billion tons of plastic produced over the last 65 years have been recycled. And every year, 8 million new tons of plastic get dumped into the oceans, which then swirl around in one of the five massive oceanographic systems called gyres, the largest of which is the size of Quebec. It's video of those plastic patches that prompted Canadian entrepreneur Michel Berthiaume to act. As he researched the problem, he found lots of earnest efforts to find solutions, but few sustainable ones.
As you know, there's hundreds of groups out there that are doing some good. They're out there cleaning beaches, cleaning islands, cleaning rivers and lakes and so forth. But it gets back to the same problem of you have this plastic that's all collected, but what happens to that plastic afterwards?
He set out to solve that problem through OceansUnited, a not-for-profit he co-founded with a $40 million endowment. They've taken a technology called hydrothermal liquefaction that converts biomass into a crude oil and spent millions improving it so that it can process any form of plastic. And while they're still waiting for a patent, he says the two units that have been built can convert 50 tons of plastic into 43,000 liters of usable biofuel daily. And all of it will be contained on a single ship, a catamaran ferry they're converting into a plastic-eating machine.
It's a current solution. There's a lot of talk about what has to be done and what we should be doing, but very few groups are out there actually going and doing it. And we're saying this is a technology that exists now. It might not be the best piece of sliced bread out there, but it's something that will help us get started.
He's also sold his first land unit to an environmental group in Nigeria, and the inquiries for more are piling up. The hardest part is the waiting. The ship won't deploy until April 22nd next year, Earth Day, trying to make the plastics in our oceans a thing of the past for a cleaner future. Mike Drolet, Global News, Toronto.